Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Simonne Kerr is pictured with her 6-year-old son Cavell, who died from complications arising from sickle cell disease in 2015. The boyfriend of an NHS nurse and gospel singer who performed in the final of Britain's Got Talent appeared in court today, charged with her murder. Desmond Sylva, 40, allegedly fatally stabbed young mother Simonne Kerr, 31, who was found with fatal injuries at a flat in a wealthy area of southwest London known as the Nappy Valley. The Old Bailey heard today that a blood-stained knife was later recovered from the kitchen sink at the scene, where paramedics had battled to save her. Sylva, who lived at the same address in Battersea, appeared at court via video link from HMP Wandsworth this morning wearing a grey prison tracksuit. Judge Sarah Munro QC remanded him in custody ahead of his next hearing on November 6 at the same court. If there is to be trial, it will take place on February 11 next year, said Judge Munro. Miss Kerr, who lived in Wembley, had dedicated her life to raising awareness of sickle cell anemia after the death of her 6-year-old son Cavell in 2015. Miss Kerr wowed audiences on ITV after appearing on Britain's Got Talent as part of the NHS choir Be Positive, created to raise awareness for blood donations. She trained as a nurse specialising in blood medicine before joining Guy's and St Thomas's Hospital in the capital. She was part of the NHS choir Be Positive, created to raise awareness for blood donations, who made it to the final stage of the ITV talent show in June. The wildcard entrance brought tears to the judges' eyes with gospel-inspired vocals, but lost to comedian Lost Voice Guy. Police said Miss Kerr was attacked in a Victorian end of terrace flat in Battersea, an area popular with affluent young families. Paramedics were called and battled for almost an hour to try and save her life before she was pronounced dead at the scene. Miss Kerr, 31, was discovered with fatal injuries at a flat in a wealthy area of southwest London. A body is removed from a home after she was found dead in an area known as Nappy Valley. The death sparked what was believed to be the 91st homicide investigation in London this year. Miss Kerr sought solace in music following the death of her son from complications linked to the inherited blood disorder. The community volunteer at the Sickle Cell Society campaigned tirelessly in his memory, overseeing a peace garden opened in his name last year. She went on to train as a nurse, qualifying in January before working as a staff nurse in haematology and oncology. Speaking ahead of her final TV performance, Miss Kerr said, "When I'm with the choir, I look either side of me and see new friends who have been affected by the same disease which took Cavell." Forensic investigators were pictured scouring the scene in Battersea for evidence last week. Residents described how armed police officers broke down the front door last Wednesday. "They know the physical and emotional pain of it. We support each other and there's a real family vibe. When we sing, we don't just rattle through a song. We sing with a real feeling that comes from the bottom of our souls." Sickle cell is caused by red blood cells that assume an abnormal shape, decreasing their flexibility and resulting in a risk of various complications. According to the NHS, doctors in Britain find it is particularly common among people of Afro-Caribbean heritage. Miss Kerr discovered she was a sickle cell disease carrier during a routine scan, and Cavell was diagnosed at only 5 days old. An empty ambulance was seen within the cordon last week, with an empty stretcher outside. A nurse and gospel singer who performed in Britain's Got Talent was found stabbed to death. She added, "I got to spend 6 wonderful years watching Cavell grow, and though there were a handful of hospitalizations in his short life, I was positive that he would live a full life into adulthood. Singing can be such an uplifting experience, so joining the Be Positive choir seemed the obvious way to raise awareness of the urgent need for more young and black people to give blood while doing something positive and motivational." Residents described how armed police officers broke down the front door at around 12:30 p.m. on Wednesday last week. Sylva, of Battersea, who will appear at the Old Bailey today, also appeared at Wimbledon Magistrates Court last Friday.